foliage of the African rainforests, two closely related primates, chimpanzees and bonobos, weave intricate social structures that revolve significantly around gender roles and relationships. Chimpanzees are often referred to as warriors, with males exhibiting dominance and holding significant control within their communities. It's crucial to note that this dominance is often maintained through aggression and violence. Male chimpanzees are known to engage in violent confrontations to establish and maintain their hierarchical positions within the community. This aggression is not only towards other males, but can sometimes be directed towards females and members of other groups, including deadly intergroup conflicts. Their muscular frames are not only their strength, but they're also strategic in forming alliances and ensuring the continuance of their lineage. Contrarily, the bonobos, termed the peacemakers, have a society where females are the binding force. Female bonobos form strong alliances, and often leadership is passed through the female line, creating a sort of matriarchal structure. Intriguingly, bonobos use sexual behaviors as a means of conflict resolution and problem solving. This behavior is quite extensive and involves members of both sexes. It helps to maintain social bonds and reduce tension within the group. In bonobo societies, sexual activities are not solely for reproduction, but play an integral part in their social structure and dynamics. This is vastly different from the patriarchal tendencies observed in chimpanzee communities. Notably, female chimpanzees, despite not being the alphas in their community, wield their own power through nurturing, grooming, and teaching the young. This aspect of nurturing and forming bonds is quite essential in their societies. Bonobos have a unique approach to social interaction and conflict resolution. They often use food and attention as social tools. Sharing, caring, and resolving conflicts amicably are trademarks of bonobo society, and this has been linked to the strong female presence within their communities. Human societies are diverse and encompass elements of both patriarchy and matriarchy. The complex nature of human interactions includes the roles of power, gender dynamics, and cooperation. Similar to chimpanzees, some human societies have historically been patriarchal, with males holding dominant positions. However, there are also examples of matriarchal societies where females hold significant influence, akin to bonobos. Human societies are distinct in their capacity for cultural evolution, and in modern times, there has been a growing emphasis on gender equality and cooperation. It is interesting to draw parallels and contrasts between these primate societies and human societies. Humans have historically had variations of patriarchal and matriarchal societies. Similar to bonobos, human societies often use food as a symbol of love and friendship. Additionally, networking and establishing relationships are crucial in human interactions, akin to the female chimpanzee's grooming for building relationships and trust. Early human societies often divided roles and responsibilities based on gender, somewhat similar to the primates. However, in modern times, human societies are evolving and gender roles are being redefined. The diversity observed in chimpanzee and bonobo societies serves as a reminder that there's no one-size-fits-all approach, and the strength of a society lies in the diversity and adaptability of roles and relationships. In the chimpanzee communities, it is important to acknowledge the role that the females play in maintaining social structure. Female chimpanzees are central in kinship, as they often keep close ties with their offspring and siblings. These bonds are crucial, especially for the younger females who learn and inherit social status from their mothers. Moreover, these relationships can influence the selection of mates, access to food resources, and support in conflicts. Females engage in grooming not just as a social bonding activity, but also as a way to alleviate stress and establish social hierarchies. Bonobo societies, on the other hand, are fascinating in their conflict resolution approaches. Unlike chimpanzees, which may sometimes resolve disputes through aggression, bonobos are renowned for resolving issues through intimate acts and affiliated behaviors. What's more interesting is that female bonobos have a unique camaraderie. They support each other in conflicts, even if it means standing up against males. This female solidarity is not as pronounced in chimpanzees. Another captivating aspect is the role of play in both societies. In bonobo societies, play is not limited to the young. Adults, particularly females, engage in playful behavior, which further cements their social bonds. In chimpanzees, play is more prevalent among the young, Serving is a way to learn social cues and physical skills that will be essential for survival and dominance as they grow. In a reflection upon the human prism, we can draw inspiration from these primates in sculpting our societies. The nurturing bonds in female chimpanzees can inspire human societies to value family ties and mentorship. The conflict resolution and camaraderie amongst bonobos can be an exemplar for creating communities based on peace, cooperation, and shared responsibilities. Moreover, examining the egalitarian structures of bonobo communities can lend insights into the benefits of gender equality and the profound impacts it can have on social harmony and collaboration. Chimpanzee societies, on the other hand, highlight the importance of alliances and the roles that both males and females play in maintaining social structures. In the realm of communication, there are also intriguing contrasts between chimpanzee and bonobo societies. Chimpanzees often employ vocalizations, facial expressions, and gestures for various reasons, including signaling alarm, coordinating movement, or demonstrating submission or reassurance. Within the males, a powerful display, which involves drumming on tree buttresses and shaking branches, is often used to assert dominance. However, in bonobo societies, communication is often more subtle and contains an array of peaceful gestures. Vocalizations and touch in bonobos are more affiliative in nature, and they tend to use these to strengthen bonds within the group. The role of food in these primate societies is another interesting facet. For chimpanzees, sharing food is often a selective process, typically happening among individuals that have strong bonds. This can be seen as a political move to strengthen alliances. In contrast, bonobos seem more egalitarian in their food sharing, often using it as an opportunity to ease tensions and build relationships. This is particularly true among the females, who might share food to build alliances that could later help in dominance or disputes. Next, let's touch on the intriguing aspect of tool use among chimpanzees. Tool use is predominantly a female activity among chimpanzees. They're often observed using sticks to fish for termites or using leaves as sponges to gather water. This skill is passed down from mothers to their offspring. On the other hand, bonobos, though capable of using tools, do not rely on them as heavily as chimpanzees. This might be due to the abundance of food in their habitats, which reduces the necessity for tools. The comparison between chimpanzee and bonobo societies raises thought-provoking questions about the origins of human gender roles and relationships. As humanity moves forward, understanding the parallels and divergences in primate societies can offer a mirror to reflect upon our own development. For example, the supportive female alliances in bonobo societies can inspire empowerment and collaboration among women and human communities. Similarly, the strategic alliances seen in male chimpanzees can shed light on leadership and cooperation dynamics in human societies. As humanity strives for social advancement, the rich tapestries of chimpanzee and bonobo societies serve as living libraries. These primates, so closely related to humans, offer invaluable lessons in understanding the fundamental nature of gender roles and relationships. By observing and learning from their social architectures, humans can explore new paradigms in building societies that are both diverse and cohesive. While observing the contrasting social structures of chimpanzees and bonobos, which reflect patriarchal and matriarchal systems respectively, allows for a deeper understanding of the origins of human gender roles and relationships. The aggression and hierarchical structure of chimpanzees, the peaceful and sexually expressive nature of bonobos, and the diverse cultural evolutions in human societies are all woven into the tapestry of social interactions and gender roles. By taking insights from these primate cousins, humans can continually reassess and shape their societies in a more reformed and empathetic manner.